Hello and welcome to this first video on Database Management System or DBMS. What is DBMS? In DBMS introduction, let me say that a DBMS is a software system that provides a centralized storage and management of data. A DBMS can be accessed and changed by multiple users in an organization. Examples of DBMS are Microsoft SQL Server, Oracle Database, and MySQL. Before creating a database in the DBMS, first we need to do conceptual database design. For that, entity relationship model in DBMS is a common technique. The entity relationship model shows entities that represent objects or concepts. For example, book or purchase. And the entity relationship model also shows relationships between those entities. For example, author writes book. This is an entity relationship diagram or ERD in Wikipedia's weak entity article. Now entities are shown in ERD as rectangles. Here order, order item, customer and product are entities. Now a rectangle or an entity has attributes that are shown as ovals. For example, the order entity has attributes order number, order date, order payment info, order shipping address. Order number attribute is underlined because it is the primary key. Now relationships are shown in ERD as diamond shapes. For example, customer entity has a relationship order author with order. 1 and M mean that one customer entity may be related to multiple order entities. A weak entity is shown in ERD as a double lined rectangle. A weak entity, for example, order item, cannot exist on its own and needs an owner entity, which is the order entity in this ERD. Here the relationship is shown as a double lined diamond. 1 and M basically mean that one order entity can be related to multiple order item weak entities. In introduction to DBMS, you should know about the relational model because the DBMS depends on it. The relational model is a mathematical model that represents data in the form of relations or tables. Now each table has rows here and columns. Each row represents an individual entity and each column represents a single attribute. For example, this row represents the individual customer whose name is Abe, and this is Abe's address, and this is Abe's customer ID. This column, customer ID, represents the customer ID attribute of the customer relation. And in every cell, it will be the individual attribute of that entity. Another relation is the customer phone numbers relation, which has all these rows and it has two columns, customer ID and phone number. Now there is a relationship between customer ID of customer phone numbers relation and the customer ID of the customer's relation. So this is called a foreign key relationship. This basically means that the customer ID of the customer phone numbers is related to the customer ID of the customer's relation. Next in this DBMS tutorial is disk storage, which refers to the physical storage of data on disks. One option in DBMS is disk striping or RAID 0. In disk striping or RAID 0, the data is divided into blocks and stored on multiple disks. And in disk striping, the data is read in parallel from multiple disks, improving the performance. But the problem is that data will be lost if one of the disks fails. In disk mirroring or RAID 1, data is stored simultaneously on multiple disks. So this is mirror 1 and this is mirror 2. Because the data is mirrored or duplicated across multiple disks, even if one of the disk fails, the data can still be retrieved from another mirrored disk. In disk duplexing or RAID 0 plus 1, the data is both striped as well as mirrored. So it provides improved performance and data mirroring. So disk duplexing is the best approach among these. Next in DBMS explanation, hashing and indexing are two separate techniques that increase database performance and fetch data faster. In hashing, there is conversion of actual data into a fixed length value called hash for quick data retrieval. The hash was called hash key earlier. This hash value is used to locate data in a table. For example, the DBMS can convert every customer name to its hash value and store it in the same table. So when you search for a customer name, say Steve, it will generate the hash and search only the hashes. So it can go to that particular customer name faster. The thing to note is that when searching hashes, the DBMS has to do arithmetic comparison with each hash. So it can do it faster than comparing strings. In indexing, a separate data structure called an index is created by the DBMS. Unlike hashes, the DBMS indexes are stored separately from the table. In this video, I explained what is database management system using my DBMS notes. I will upload more DBMS tutorials for beginners like this video. For example, in the next video, I will explain about schema, DBMS, structure, etc. So please view this complete database management system full course in the Database Management System in English playlist. Thank you.